for the introduction, and good morning, everyone. And I would like to start by thanking KeyStep for inviting me to present on the UNDP's work related to innovation. I'm really humbled to be at the same panel with a lot of representatives of the scientific community, and I must say that my presentation will stand out a little bit from the presentations of my other co-panelists, because based on the experience of my organization, I will not be talking about the scientific innovation, but we'll talk about different other aspects of innovation. But as it was highlighted in the brilliant keynote speech, the current framework of that we have towards 2030 requires a lot of integration of different communities. Nevertheless, in order to make the connection to the overall theme of the meeting, I would like to tell a few words of my organization and where it came from with regards to the support to the science and technology and innovation. We have a very long history in the Republic of Korea. This year, UNDP turns 50 globally, and it turns 50 in Korea, because it started working here from the 60s. The distinctive feature of our program in Korea has been the fact that it was very science and technology heavy. For instance, when we started working in the 60s, some of the examples of the projects would include the science education. In the 70s, we proceeded to support scientific technological information center, as well as support all the fledgling industries that the government of Korea has been supporting at the time. For instance, semiconductor technology. In the 80s, we moved on to support the more advanced technologies, including vacuum. In the 90s, the attention turned towards environment and environmental technology, whereas in the few years before the closure of the country office, a lot of attention was focused on how to share the policies that Korea had on science and technology with other countries. There were large sharing programs, for instance, with Vietnam, Nepal, Tunisia, that resulted in adaptation of a lot of Korean experiences elsewhere. But this is just an introduction of where we come from, and now let me turn to what we try to do in the current context of the Sustainable Development Goals. Sustainable Development Goals is obviously a transformational agenda, as it was described. The combination of the SDGs, the Sendai framework, the Paris Agreement, requires a lot of change to the business as usual, and it has implication towards the business model of different organizations, including the international organizations like the one which I represent. There are different ways to go about it, and innovation can be an external function that organization relies upon occasionally. It can be a part of the organization, or it can be the integral part of all aspects of our organization's work. Well, in Asia, we have set the direction towards the latter, how to make innovation the integral part of our work. And it requires, obviously, a very significant transformation of the business model departure from the known ways of doing projects, promotion of culture of taking risks, learning by doing. So what is the mechanism for generation of the new ideas? I mean, obviously, it starts from the identification of the problem, and in some contexts, it's also not an easy task, because in most cases, identification of the problem is a political issue. It then requires the generation of ideas on addressing this problem. The incubation of the problem, of the solution, prototyping and implementation, and then taking it up to scale. Currently, we have more approaches or tools for each of the stages, for each of the step in the cycle. It starts from tools of engagement of the people, harnessing their creativity in the process, and the use of new technologies. This is to illustrate our short journey in Asia on trying to mainstream innovation in our work. We started from 2014 with the regional meeting, bringing together a number of development practitioners, including people from the science community, to a meeting in Bangkok to discuss the regional innovation. We created an innovation fund last year in 2015, and this year we started developing new initiatives around the sustainable development goals, as well as creating new partnerships and providing capacity building both to the country offices, and we work in all the Asian countries, as well as to our government counterparts. Well, in the first year of our conscious investment in innovation, we saw a number of new ideas already prototyped, engaging a number of non-traditional partners and showing some initial results. For example, in Nepal, the innovators challenged the gender stereotypes using gaming and animation techniques. In Bhutan, we also partnered with the gaming lab to address the issue of youth unemployment. In China, we partnered with Beidou to address the issue of electronic waste, and so on. In 2015, we saw a number of this initiative taking to scale. For example, in Maldives, the Make My Island application that was developed with pro bono support from the UK initiative Fix My Street was officially launched and scaled to the capital region by the Minister of Environment. The China's e-waste initiative that I already mentioned was scaled to 22 cities, and the partnership with Baidu yielded 4.5 million Chinese yuan. In PNG, the partnership with Mobi Media was also further scaled up with the support of Australian aid. So here are some innovation highlights from 2015. For example, in Nepal, we partnered with Microsoft to better manage debris collection, and also log the real-time data to ensure accurate payments under the Cash for Work program in addressing the earthquake recovery. This is one of the concrete examples for using innovation in response to the Sendai framework. There are many examples of using innovation and preparedness as well. In Bangladesh, we used some behavioral insights to identify reasons that inhibit public transport usage by citizens. And as you know, big cities in Bangladesh are suffering from very heavy traffic. So the model based on the GPS tracking system allowed the real-time access to data on the movements of traffic and buses. As I mentioned, now in 2016, because the Sustainable Development Goals were approved last year, we started developing of the new programs that respond to the SDG framework. It includes alternative financing aims to develop a portfolio of experiments that cover a variety of mechanisms and innovations across Asia and the Pacific region. As I seem to be running out of time, I'll just give you a few more examples. This is an example of using drones for disaster risk reduction and in Maldives, which is an innovative partnership. And this is also an example of using the virtual reality in our communications work, because we also have a problem of not knowing how to communicate well. The other important area, and this is something which has been used across Asia, is harnessing the potential of youth, and it includes a number of examples. The examples of disaster preparedness, for instance, in Bangladesh, examples of developing vision and using the foresight in Sri Lanka, then the social innovation camps in Thailand, and so on. Let me also highlight that the cities are a very important place of innovation, and with Seoul being one of the important champions, both using big data and open data, having very innovative in e-governance applications, as well as a very innovative civic engagements model in addressing the city problems. This resulted in proposing this year of establishment of so-called City iLeaps initiative. It's a learn, exchange, adapt, prototype, and scale that brings together the cities that would like to share urban innovations, adapt them, or do both. I just wanted to say that innovations it's not only about the development of the new product, but it's also about the processes and about the new ways of partnerships with the partners that have not been traditional. And for us, it included a lot of exploration of working together with the new partners. It's already receiving a lot of attention in the media. Here are a few examples of the work that we do in Asia. I think I'll stop here, and I will be glad to answer any questions on the innovation work in Asia, as well as on the past of my organization here in Korea, where it had a significant role in promoting science and technology. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lee. Thank you.